passed away, so we are doing a special tribute to one of Kenya's finest artists and rappers who paved the way for so many
legendary
others. Of course, we've got the one and only Big Pin Jatelo in the building. Make some noise for him. We're just going to, you know, remember Issa, the good, the music,
the
everything.
Music.
Yep. Yeah.
Stardom.
Stardom.
Greatness, yeah, and all that. So tell us, like, you know, what are some of the fun, I always think, and this happens to everybody, I think of, like, how would it be today
if Issa was alive?
Yeah.
Yeah, everyone keeps asking that. If guys are thinking, I probably think he'd be in the level of Wizkid and maybe more. Mm-hmm. But I know his passion mostly was production. So I think what I feel is he would have probably entered into production, maybe owned a recording house, have artists under him. That was like his main, like his career ending plan, you get. Mm. Yeah, so probably that's what he would have been.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, he was only 21 years old when he passed, and yet he's still one of the greatest. Like, so there's still like so much more that he could have achieved. But if you can just take us back to that time, early 2000s. What was the music scene like here in Kenya while Issa was around?
Well, the music scene was, I mean, we all know it was crazy. We actually listen to his songs still now.
Right.
14 years down the line, this is a guy who had, I think, one video. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I mean, his songs, most of what has been played, Boomba Train, you have Bamba, you have Hamnitishi. I mean, for an artist, that's legendary already. For you to have your songs playing 14 years after you pass on, that's like Bob Marley or Michael Jackson or Lucky Dube.
Right.
So yeah, I mean, and then the music scene then was really vibrant, you know. It was competition, it was, we were young, I was 17, he was 18 when I was recording my first single on You're Doing Joe. You know, we were just from high school, we had energy, we had psych, we were raw, you know, we were craving for everything to do. So our whole, he was a Biggie fan. I was a Tupac fan, so that's how we used to argue. It's like, Biggie in boxing, Tupac, you know, that argument which never ends. Yeah. So that's when he decided, you know what, let's talk about Biggie and Tupac. As guys, you can rap, I can rap, let's think of doing something in the studio. And that's how we just started. So the passion just came. We actually just did it. We never even knew anything about fame. We never wanted to be famous. We just wanted to prove that we could rap and represent our hood.
And so even today, I guess, you know, even as we continue, you know, remember his music, and that he was such a lyricist and a perfectionist. What are some of the things that you remember about him that, you know, stand out and maybe you can borrow into the entertainment music scene now?
I think it's just for for the upcoming people, it's just, I think most of it is passion. Don't go to a studio to record so that you can have many Instagram followers or just be seen on YouTube. If you're not, it's just love. Just we used to sit down the whole night and just watch Channel O, get ideas, write. By the time we go in the studio, we have like 10 songs. We're telling the producer, okay, jana tuliandika ngoma 10. Gani ndio unapenda hapa? Like that. So I think it's just, and if you really love music, it'll never die. It's part of you. Sit down, you listen, you write, you record, and that's the kind of person he was. He was always that, like, Big Pin, Buske. I remember they sing for me, like, Boomba Train. I just listen to this idea. So it goes like this. This is without a beat, without anything. So just that, it goes like, boom, boomba. So I'm telling him, what does boomba even mean? Boomba ni nini kwanza? And it's a sound, like, you know, you feel in the club, laugh ngoma in a tune and some boomba. I miss it. Miss a lovely concept, yako. But he was, I mean, he could think, he had a, He was way of his league, you know.
Yeah, even his
way ahead of his time. His lyrics, his Swahili, you know, he was half Tanzanian, half Kenyan. So yeah, that's Swahili sanifu. Then how he used to arrange it and whatnot. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What do you think you would have to say to you know, a young artist today? Like, what type of advice would Issa have for somebody who's, you know, just starting out in the music scene right now, trying to be legendary?
Okay. Okay. I don't know what you'd say, but probably just the same thing which I'm just saying. Just, I mean, he was a talker. He used to be that guy for, let's sit down, let's have a conversation. You know me, I'm not a guy for conversations. Like, okay, let's talk about this. It's like, and he really loved, like, music. Like, that was like, if he was sleeping, he had earphones on. If he was walking, he had earphones on. If he's in the studio, if he's in whatever, he was just playing something. He just listened to this part. So he was just I think he's just born to be a musician. Yeah, and a poet, I mean.
Cool
stuff.
I mean, his music lives on for sure. I think we've just seen just from the crowd reaction as the DJ was playing his songs.
Yeah.
It'll live on for a very long time, so he will not be forgotten anytime soon. You know, rest in peace to Issa, but the music definitely lives on.
Lives on for sure.
Thank you so much, Big Pin, for being here, sharing those memories.
For sure.
Next time, unakuja una rock mic kidogo.
I'm minister. Limu retire.
But yeah, so thank you so much for coming through. Of course, the show does continue here on 10 over 10. That
for
has
sure.
been our Issa tribute, our special Issa tribute, 14 years after his passing. Like we said, the music lives on. This is 10 over 10. Keep using the hashtag 10 over 10. Much more coming up next.